Alright, this is just going to be a quick video to show generally how the Logan's Run Deep Sleep Flame Pistol functions. This particular version is 3D printed, but the difference in this one than any of the ones that are currently available or have seen online is that this one actually has all the internal workings of the flame pistol to kind of physically show how it actually functions in the real world. The flame gun actually does produce flame out the tip here, so basically it is a handheld flamethrower. So right now I've taken the screws. There's one here. I've loosened that up so that I could actually open this up and remove the side and things like that, so we can actually see what is on the inside. Basically, what happens is you put calcium carbide pellets or powder in the chamber here in the back, a little bit of water, which will produce acetylene gas. The gas then goes down a tube to a valve to keep it from escaping, so the valve itself holds it back. Then when you're ready to fire, you flip on the glow plug. Be a glow plug here at the very tip. There's a nozzle right here that allows the gas to come out after you've actually pressed the trigger. Okay, so once you release the gas, it comes out the nozzle portion here. This is a flame suppressor that actually causes the flame to not only come out the tip, but it also comes out the four slots here. So I'm going to go ahead and open this up and we can take a look at what actually is happening. So I'm going to set this down. This cover again is just set on there. Normally it's held in with screws. We can go ahead and take a look at this. This is the trigger. Okay, so what happens, you push the trigger in, it opens the valve, releasing the gas. So I'm going to go ahead and also remove the back here. This is the part that is actually unthreadable. It can be unthreaded and cleaned between shots, because once you've put your calcium carbide and water in here, it does produce a kind of a leftover byproduct. Right here is what they call a snorkel, and the reason for that is once you've put the calcium carbide and water in there, you don't want it coming out the hole here, you know. So if you're moving the gun around, you don't want anything plugging up the hole, so they've added a snorkel so that nothing can actually get down into the main line here. So this is actually the gas escape area. This is a tube that allows the gas to come out here. Okay, so also the cap itself has a hole in the side of it. I don't know if you can see that there, but there's actually a hole here. So when you partially thread it in, you then take a syringe and you inject a pre-measured amount of water into the hole, into the chamber, and then you can tighten that up, and that actually creates a seal. There's a O-ring that would be placed here, another O-ring here, so that when this is threaded in there, it's sealed all the way from here through and into this portion here, which we'll go ahead and slip that out. This here is normally made of brass, because you can silver solder to it. This would be the brass piece with a filtered material in there, so this would actually thread onto there like that. So now we have a sealed unit all the way up. There'd be another O-ring located right here, and the gas then would then come out this tube. So to keep it from coming out even further, that's where the valve comes into effect. So I'm going to go ahead and take this off here. Okay, so this is the suppressor. This is a glow plug right here, which will ignite the gas. So what'll happen is, let me go ahead and take this off here, so we can see this. Release this here if I can. Here we go. Okay, take that out like that. So this is the actual working of it. So we're going to put this back in here. And normally, the seal would, again, there'd be an O-ring. We have the valve right here. So when you push the trigger, it opens a valve, which releases the gas into the front area here. This is a brass tube, and there are two holes, one on each side. This allows air to enter through these holes, which would be called a venturi. So when the gas comes down the center tube, it's like a needle valve in there. When it comes down here, the gas escapes out the front. The air is then pulled in due to the venturi effect, and you have an air-gas mixture here. So I'm going to go ahead and this is threaded in here. This would be considered the needle valve right here. And then this, again, would be threaded into there to hold all that together. You pull the trigger, and then now you have air and gas mixture coming out here, and it then would go into the suppressor and be ignited by the glow plug. The glow plug is actually turned on by this little switch and activated by a battery that is located down in here. So once you've turned on the glow plug, you pull the trigger, it releases the gas, comes out the tip, and ignites in the suppressor itself. So I just wanted to kind of show the actual workings of the flame gun. This is a close approximation to what I gathered from the blueprints. So again, we have the battery, we've got the trigger, and this spring is actually there to hold the valve in the closed position. There would be an O-ring also right here so that it keeps a nice good seal. You don't want any gas escaping out any part of the back portion of the prop itself. So again, this is all okay. Once the screw is put in here, it holds all this together so that this doesn't come out or anything like that. So again, once you take this out and you unthread this, you have your filter material in there. You've got your gas chamber here. It threads in with the O-ring. You have the cap. You have the snorkel, and that's it. So you have your calcium carbide and water mixture, produces acetylene gas. So when you do go to clean it, I guess, again, not having a real one, I would assume you would unthread this. You would maybe clean out the filter, put new filtering material in there, unthread this, run some water in there, clean this out so you get rid of all the byproduct, because there will be some, essentially either a powder or maybe a paste, depending on how much water you put in there. If you put more water than needed, it will mix with the leftover byproduct and create a bit of a paste. So anyway, you just clean that out, let it dry, and you go for it again. You put it all back together like this. It's essentially just more of a close rendition to what the prop would look like. But this is it. This is the only one in existence and the only one that is in full detail, just like that. All right, thank you for watching.